who have taught the hearts of the faithful by the light of the Holy Spirit, grant that in the same Spirit we may be truly wise and ever rejoice in his consolation. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Please be seated as we listen to the Word of God.
A reading from the book of Sirach. All wisdom is from the Lord and remains with him forever. The sands of the sea, the drops of rain, the days of eternity, who can count them? Heaven's height, earth's extent, the abyss and wisdom, who can explore them? Before all things, wisdom was created and created understanding from eternity. The root of wisdom, to whom has it been revealed? Her subtleties, who knows them? There is but one, wise and truly awesome, seated upon his throne, the Lord. It is he who created her, saw her, and measured her, poured her forth upon all his works, upon every living thing, according to his bounty, lavished her upon those who love him. The fear of the Lord is glory and exaltation, gladness and a festive crown. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the first letter of Timothy. Do not let people disregard you because you are young, but be an example to all the believers in the way you speak and behave, and in your love, your faith, and your purity. Make use of the time until I arrive by reading to the people, preaching, and teaching. You have a spiritual gift which was given to you when the prophets spoke and the body of the elders laid their hands on you. Do not let it stand unused. Think hard about all this and put it into practice, and everyone will be able to see how you are advancing. Take great care about what you do and what you teach. Always do this, and in this way, you will save both yourself and those who listen to you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Since you went into the shelter in sometimes it's not enough. There's more. And so what you're going to be embarking on from here is you're going to be embarking on a whole other level of education. We have done our best to lay this foundation for you. And we have given it our all. And you know, you guys are really in a great place in terms of your education and your spiritual formation. But it doesn't end here. This is not the end. You are now called to season your life with more salt, with the salt of the Lord. And to go out, and as the second part of this gospel says, to go out and be a light for the world. How fitting it is, maybe it's not fitting, but how crazy it is that this has been our Jubilee year, 60 years as an institution. And at the beginning of the year, Sister commissioned a song to be sung, and it was about light. It was about being a light. So you all, you graduates, are now tasked to go out and be that light to others. Be salt of the earth. And you've got the support system to help you do that. You've got the foundation to make that happen. You all don't realize what a historical moment this is, and what a historical class you are. The class of 2020 is going down in the history books, guys, as an incredible, incredible, unprecedented year. You are a part of that, whether you liked it or not. It's been a challenge all the way around. But here we are. Actually doing a new thing here, a baccalaureate mass. Usually we do a graduation. But no, a baccalaureate mass, a graduation mass. This is also something new that the Lord has drawn out of this pandemic. So let's not just look at the negative aspect of it. Yeah, the negativity we experience, but rather let's flip that side. It's like you flip that bird and look at the positive side. There's been so much grace that God has given us. And so let's celebrate that tonight. Let's give thanks to God for that tonight. And to the class of 2020, I remember Sister saying, you know, we will Vision 2020 vision will be kind of a theme. I hope you gain some 2020 vision throughout this process. And as you go forth from your career, your educational, formational career at Mary Immaculate, go with our love. And go knowing that we've done all we can to kind of catapult you into the next level of education and formation in your lives. Together, let's stand and offer our prayers and petitions to the Lord.
For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, Bishop Edward Burns, Bishop Gregory Kelly, and for all bishops and priests, may their kindness be known to all as they preach the truth in charity. We pray to the Lord. For all people in positions of authority, may they always seek the common good, and may they be open to be guided by the wisdom and prudence of God in all their decisions. We pray to the Lord. For all those who are ill, and for all those who suffer from anxieties, may they find healing and greater freedom in the Lord. We pray to the Lord. For all those who have assisted the graduating class in their years at Mary Immaculate School, especially their parents, administrators, teachers, priests, and coaches. May these many parts of the one body of Christ be blessed for their generous and often sacrificial love. We pray to the Lord.
Amen.
For the Mary Immaculate class of 2020, as they are sent forth by Christ to their various high schools, may they, who are the salt of the earth and the light of the world, continue to shine brightly with his light in their words and actions. We pray to the Lord. For all those who have died striving to love the Lord with all their heart and strength, and especially for the family members who have died at the class of 2020, may they praise God with the angels and saints this day. We pray to the Lord. For the intentions of the class of 2020 for whom this Mass is being offered, we pray to the Lord.
Heavenly Father, you hear all our prayers and you know our needs. We place them before you now and ask that you grant them. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Angels. in some other way. His suffering was ended. He took the chalice. And once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Humbly we pray that by remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, and Edward, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, and with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may marry to be coerced into the life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him.
Thank you.
we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Let us pray. May the outpouring of the Holy Spirit cleanse our hearts, O Lord, and make them fruitful by the inner sprinkling of His dew, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated for a presentation.
Understanding, to be willing to act in a manner pleasing to Him. Remember that He Congratulations, class of 22.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. It was a joy to be here.